Must I be bound while you go free? Must I love one who never loved me? Must I enact such a childish part and follow one who will break my heart? For the first thing that my love gave me, it was a cap all lined with lead. And the longer that I wore that cap, it grew the heavier on my head. You gave me a mantle for to wear, lined with grief and stitched with care. The drink you gave me was bitter gall, and the blows you gave to me were worse than all. And the last thing that my love gave me, it was a belt with collars three. And the first was pain, and the next was sorrow, and the last it was sad misery. But I will climb up that high, high tree, and I will rob that wild bird's nest, and I will fall without a fear, and find me one that loves me the best. Must I be bound while you go free? Must I love one who never loved me? Must I enact such a childish part and follow one who will break my heart?
My mind I dare not move, nor ne'er can break it. She doth so far excel all and each other. My mind I cannot tell when we are together. I will reveal it. I'll try the constancy, I'll not conceal it.
do nothing till you leave me. Pay no attention to what's said. Why people tear the seam of anyone's dream is over my. Consider our romance. If you should take the word of others you've heard, I don't stand a chance. True, I've been seen with someone new, but does that mean that I'm untrue? When we're apart, the words in my heart reveal how I feel about you. Some kiss may haunt my memory, and other arms may. Do nothing till you hear it from me, and you never will. And you never will.
And just in case you were wondering just what the first part of this concert might be about, well, after those three, you shouldn't be. I think we can subtitle it The Path of True Love, in brackets. Never did run smooth. The first song, one of the fine examples which proliferate throughout our traditional music. Must I be bound while you go free? The second, a song about just not being able to say those words, I love you, when you really want to. That's from the mid part of the 17th century. We've been getting this wrong for a while. So don't feel alone, don't feel awkward. We've all done it, and they did it, and them before did it too. And the last one, Duke Ellington's Do Nothing Till You Hear From Me. And everybody says I'm a bastard, but I'm not really. Honest. Honest. And I leave you to decide who's telling the truth. But love songs don't necessarily come in the form you might expect them. This, written some years ago by the blessed Richard Thompson, is based on a Sufi poem, which says, when you've given up, when you think you are alone, and will be alone for the rest of your life, look again. God is waiting. Strange affair.
This is a strange affair. Time has come to travel, but the road is filled with fear. This is a strange affair. My youth has all been wasted, and I'm bent and gray with years. And all my companions are taken away. My dying day, I took my own provisions, but they fooled me and wasted away. Oh, where are my companions? My father, mother, lover, friend, and enemy. Oh, where are my companions? They're prisoners of death now and taken far from here. Where are the dreams I dreamed in the days of my youth? They took me to illusion when they promised me the truth. Sleepers need to make them listen. Why do they need more proof? This is a strange, this is a strange affair. Thank you.
won't you give me an answer? Why is your heart so hard towards the one who loves you best? The man with the answer has wakened you and warned you and called you to the test. Wake up from the sleep that builds like clouds upon your eyes. Win back the life you had that's now a dream of lies. Turn your back on yourself, and if you follow, you will win the lover's prize. This is a strange, strange
often, right at the bottom of dreadful deeds or crime, you'll find that love or love gone wrong definitely was working its naughty ways. And this song is no exception. It speaks of, amongst the notorious riding families of the borderlands between England and Scotland, the worst. Agreed by all, on both sides, and the family themselves, they were definitely the worst of a bad bunch. And their name was Graham. So if there's any Grahams in the audience, I'm sorry, and I didn't mean a word of it, and I don't want to see you outside afterwards, okay? So here is one of their number, one Huw Graham. His life to now has been a constant round of cattle rustling, theft, arson, and blood feud. And one day, he just happens to steal a horse. Nothing in his life except this horse belongs to the Bishop of Carlisle. And the bishop isn't very pleased. So when the bishop's men are out riding one day and they come across Huw Graham on his own, they nab him quick. They rope him to a horse and they ride him into Carlisle. There's only going to be one end, and it's on a rope. But that's not quite all the story. Huw Graham.
Lords are to the mountains gone a hunting of the fallow deer. They have gripped Huw Graham for stealing of the bishop's mare. They have bound him hand and foot, led him up through Carlisle town. All the lads along the way cried, Huw Graham, you shall have. Loose my right arm free, he says, put my broadsword in my hand. There's none in Carlisle town this day dare tell a tale to Huw Graham. Spoke the good white ford as he sat by the bishop's knee. 500 white stots I'll give you if you'll give Huw Graham to me. Hold your tongue, my noble lord, and if you're bleeding, let it be. Although 10 Grahams were in his coat, Huw Graham this day shall die. She sat by the bishop's knee. 500 white pence I'll give you if you'll let Huw Graham go free. Hold your tongue, my lady fair, and if you're bleeding, let it be. Although 10 Grahams were in his coat, it's for my honour he must die. Tree.
Ne'er the color left his cheek, nor ever did he blink his eye. Then he's looked him round about, all for to see what he could see. There he spied his father dear, weeping, weeping bitterly. Hold your tongue, my father dear, and if you're weeping, let it be. It sore, sore grieves my heart than all that they could do to me. And you may give my brother John my sword that's made of the metal clear. Tell him come at 12 of the clock and see me pay the bishop's mare. You may give my brother James my sword that's made of the metal brown. Tell him come at 4 of the clock and see his brother Hugh cut down. Remember me to Maggie, my wife, the next time you gone o'er the moor. Tell her she stole the bishop's mare. Tell her she was the bishop's whore. Their blood when next they meet the bishop's cloak, even shorter by the hood. The hanging hill that they took Hugh to was at Harrowby. Then was just outside Carlisle. These days it's the northwestern headquarters of the Inland Revenue, so some things don't change much, do they?
Thank you.
second half of this concert concerns songs that have a very definite sense of place. Their subject can be, well, damn near anything, but with each song, you could not be anywhere in the world but that one specific place. And there, the June hedgerows of southern England, words from Bob Copper. This next song, just as English, but very different, a northern landscape, seen through the eyes of Lyle Waterson.
One summer's morn, saw a scarecrow tied to a pole in a field of corn. His coat was black and his head was bare. When the wind shook him, the crows took up into the air. Thank you.
one summer's moon, saw a scarecrow tied to a pole in a field of corn. Always once I loved Thomas, and then I loved John. Then I loved William, he's a clever young man, with his white coat and stockings and his low ankle shoes. And he wears a blue jacket wherever he goes. So it's tie a yellow handkerchief in remembrance of me. Wear it around your neck, my love, in flash company. Flash company, my boys, like so many more. If it hadn't been for flash company, I'd never have been so poor. Always fiddling and dancing, they were all my delight. Keeping flash company, it has ruined me quite. It has ruined me quite, me boys, like a great many more. If it hadn't been for flash company, I'd never have been so poor. So it's tie a yellow handkerchief in remembrance of me. Wear it around your neck with all in flash company. Flash company, my boys, like so many more. If it hadn't been for flash company, I'd never have been so bored. Oh, but once I had a colour as red as the rose. Now I'm as pale as the lily that grows, like a flower in the garden, all the colour is gone. Don't you see what I am come through by loving such a one? So it's tie a yellow handkerchief in remembrance of me. Wear it around your neck, my love, in flash company. Flash company, my boys, like so many more. If it hadn't been for flash company, I'd never have been so poor.
That delightful celebration of a life of indulgence, I think is the best way to put it, was collected, that particular version, from an old man called Eli Sterry in a very famous pub, The Ship, at Black's Hall in Suffolk. And you would think from that maybe Eli was one of the lads going in there drinking every night, singing to a ripe old age. But Eli was different, because Eli was a gypsy. And for all his acceptance in certain fields, certain ways, he was still apart. Eli could have told you a thing or two about what it was like to be a gypsy, from the turn of the century through to the middle of this one. Eli could have told you what it was like to see the land and the life changing, to see the growth of the big farms and the slipping away of the seasonal work that kept gypsy families alive. No more potato picking, no more hops, no more peas. No one wanting pots and pans mended anymore. No one needing horses. For now we live in an age of plastic and of agribusiness. And the life of the gypsy has become a very difficult one. They never belonged, and now they have no tenuous grip on our society. So next time you pass them on the road, next time maybe you see the lay-bys blocked with the great piles of gravel to stop them stopping by the way, next time you read in the paper of yet another gypsy site being refused, we don't want them near us, do we? Spare a thought for the likes of Eli and Jeannie and Davy and Belle, the keepers of our music, the gypsies for whom all our trades are gone. We'll sit here in the morning of the summer on the month of May, when the year is old and it is raining, while you think before you turn away, before you left us sitting here while the years were passing. Now all our trades are gone and we are moved on. Always moved on. Oh, your working day is passing slowly, and you're thinking of the evening time. And we're running wild through your city, all your working days have passed us by. For you left us sitting here. Years were passing. Now all our trades are gone, and we are moved on, always moved on. Oh, the night is passing slowly, and the weary city slips away. And we're sitting here in the shadows, you've forgotten for another day. For you left us sitting here when the years were passing. Now all our trades are gone and we are moved on, always moved on. Is old and it is raining, when you think before you turn away, for you left us sitting here while the years were passing. Now all our trades are gone and we are moved on, always moved on. This next piece that is speaks of a sense of place. It's about this place where we live. This place that we have to look after. A place called England.
Morning like a hero in a song, looking for a place called England, trying to find where I belong. Couldn't find the old flood meadow or the house that I once knew. No trace of that little river or the garden where I grew. I saw town, I saw country melt away and sink estate. Rich man in his rolling acres, poor man still outside the gate. Retail park and burger kingdom, prairie field and factory farm, run by men who think that England's only a place to park their car. But as the train station through the wastelands of despair, from the corner of my eye a brightness filled the filthy air. Someone sown a patch of sunflowers, though the soil is sooty black. Marigolds and a few tomatoes right beside the railway houses in between the concrete towers, compost heaps and scarlet runners, secret gardens full of flowers. Meter grows her scented roses right beneath the big jet's path. Bid a fortune for her garden, Eileen turns away and laughs. So wake up, Georgia. Rise up, Arthur, time to rouse up from your sleep. Deck the horse with sea green ribbons, drag the old sword from the deep. Hold the line for Dave and Daniel as they tunnel through the clay, while the oak in all its glory soaks up sun for one more day. Whatever the land that gave you birth, there's room for you both root and branch, as long as you love this English earth. Room for vole and room for orchid, room for all to grow and thrive. Just less room for the fat banana on his ass and his four-wheel drive. For England is not flag or empire, it is not money and it is not blood. It's limestone gorge and granite fell, it's weald and clay and seven mud. It's blackbird singing from the May tree, lark ascending through the scales. It's robin watching from your spade, and English earth beneath your nails. So here's two cheers for a place called England, sore abused but not yet dead. A Mr. Harding sort of England, hanging in there by a thread. Here's two cheers for the crazy diggers, now their hour shall come around. We shall plant the seed they saved us, common wealth and common crown. Here's two cheers for the crazy diggers, now their hour is come.
Thank you very much, and I would like to thank, I'm sure you would too, Mark Emerson, Andy Cutting, Mark Lockheart, Tim Harries, Martin Simpson, and Huw Warren. It's very hard to follow Maggie Holland's amazing song, A Place Called England, but I think this one will complement it, written by another great English writer, Cyril Tawney. Cyril served in the Royal Navy in the 1950s, stationed in Malta and round the Mediterranean, and he wrote many fine songs about his life then. This one speaks of the time that comes to every sailor, when if you want a life of your own, you have to turn your back on the sea, keep it turned forever. Because if you don't, she'll call you back. And she won't brook any difficulties, complaints, obstacles, or any other lovers. She wants you for herself. In the 50s, all the great shipping lines that still plied the sea lanes of the world were known by nicknames that related to the insignia on their funnels. The White Star Line, the Blue Cross Line. The ships of the Royal Navy had funnels of plain gunmetal grey. So the seamen called her the Grey Funnel Line.
It's one more day on the gray funnel line. The finest chill that tears the sea. Dreams were only real.
we're homeward bound, and it's one more day on the grave.
With us for Jazz on BBC Four from Ella Fitzgerald. Next.